Here they come. Do what you must.
Great ball of light coming your way!
Whoa! That looks like it hurts!
Do not worry about me!
Right side, it's coming!
Figure out how they're making light bridges.
Look at this statue, these crystals. I've noticed them on the elves as well. I wonder, if this statue were to fall over the chasm,
crystals still make light bridges. Now the light elves wear them. Smart.
Almost there. Allow me.
I dare say he's beginning to enjoy the vandalism. Pretty soon he'll be laying waste to pottery.
Shall we continue? Well, at least we're getting closer. Look up. See?
It feels even taller on the inside. I can't believe all this was down here.
Ah, the Nornir. Why must they insist on these frustrating trials?
You would know better than us, Bubba.
I can't remember the last time I visited the Norns, nor do I wish to try.
Go!
chopper!
Take Ball of Light, coming your way!
Why must they insist on this frustrating trial?
You would know better than us, brother.
I can't remember the last time I visited the Nords, nor do I wish to try. Twilight Stone. Nice. Seeing it again.
Look, over there.
And here we go again.
Brighter than I remember.
Another light door.
There's some Twilight Stone on that statue shield, but that angle isn't gonna work. Do you think there's any way to stop the elves from fighting each other?
Had Freyr not abandoned the realm, the lasting peace may have formed. Now.
Can we really place all the blame on Freyr?
This war started long before his arrival.
But he had the power to heal this land and end the war, did he not?
He made his choice.
The wrong one.
For Alfheim, perhaps. But not necessarily for him.
Well, I suppose we're all entitled to walk our own paths, regardless of where they end.
Get off him! Jump!
Getting stuck on the wing.
The shield moved. There must be a way to move this statue's Twilight Stone to get the right angle.
Last time we were here, we killed the Dark Elf King.
That's unfortunate. I'd wondered what became of Svarti Ofrin.
We had to defend ourselves. But when he died, he told us we helped the wrong side.
I see. You still hear something wounded out there, Atreus.
I think so. It could just be the storm.
Perhaps we can investigate, once we've uncovered a mysterious seer's hidden prophecy.
there. The central chamber will bring us to the top. Once we find our way past yet another light door.
There's some sandstone up there.
It pairs quite nicely with the Twilight Stone. A knack for interiors, these light elves.
It's facing the wrong way. Maybe if we...
Allow me to speed this up. The angle should work, Kratos.
Well done.
At your service. The light of Alfheim. How stunning. Your father is indeed thorough.
Limitless. Limitless what? Power? Growth? Ambition? A bit vague, innit?
Nothing.
What's wrong?
I could hear Mother inside last time, but I can't anymore.
Her soul is one with the light now, united by forces older than Odin himself. She is at peace, Atreus.
I hope so. When Father went inside the light, he said
he... went inside the light of Alfheim?
Yes.
And yet here you stand, of sound mind and decidedly not incinerated. You must tell me, Kratos, what did you see?
That memory is for me alone. But I felt only moments pass.
Didn't feel like moments to me.
I was trapped. Atreus overcame great odds to save me.
One could but only imagine. Well then, Groa's triptych awaits.
So, did you ever meet Groa?
Many times. But she was plagued by constant visions, so... conversation was... difficult, to say the least.
doing?
I heard something.
Father, she's... she's gone. We're almost there. Huh. They've changed some stuff. Last time, there was all this hive stuff up here. So many Dark Elves. All this time, I thought the Dark Elf King... I thought all the Dark Elves were... here?
Yes.
Did we help the wrong side?
Are you certain that's the right question?
What's the right question?
Is there a right side?
Exactly. What do you think, Atreus? Is there a right side to this war?
I don't know.
Then perhaps you shouldn't pick one.
Go!
Is right there.
Yeah, but there was a Nornir chest down here last time. Oh, guess they moved it.
There it is.
Ah, you all made it. Welcome.
Appreciate it.
Do you believe in fate, Sindri?
Oh, of course not. You think I'd wash my hands this much if I thought that what I do doesn't ultimately matter? There's only one thing with any say over how we live our lives, and that's us. At your service. And Atreus? Fashionable. Tasteful. Kratos? I'll take him.
giants always did enjoy hiding their secrets in plain sight.
Wait until you see this.
Ah, yes. Here we have Grua's search for her missing husband. She was relentless in her attempt to find him. Meditated for weeks on end. Unfortunately, she found something else. A vision of Ragnarok.
Word of Grua's vision reached Odin. He sought her out, demanded a private retelling.
Didn't like what he heard, apparently.
Ironwood? That's the... I don't know what that is.
The mythical sanctuary for giants. Curious.
So it's in Jotunheim?
I know some giants thought so, but Ironwood isn't anywhere, lad. It's a concept, a metaphorical paradise. It's not real.
Presumably, Grua requested her ashes be returned to Jotunheim, while her soul found peace in the light. Difficult to imagine Odin respecting those wishes. The champion?
I think it's supposed to be... me.
You assume too much.
Aye. Best not to read into these abstractions so literally. Prophecies are slippery by nature. Although, some are more obvious than others.
Ragnarok.
Aye. The end of everything.
So this is it. There's nothing we can do to stop it.
There must be a way. Why else is this hidden?
Look. Tyr. This is what we saw. It's you. Fighting in Ragnarok.
No. I don't... I can't.
What's this then? That's new.
Asgard is destroyed? But the other realms thrive?
She did. Odin's working off a false prophecy.
So then, we can win Ragnarok. We can beat Odin.
We are not present in any of this.
But that was Tyr leading the charges against Asgard. Plus, Hel's army was there. And the elves. Champion. Okay. Whoever that is, doesn't matter. But for the first time, we know something Odin doesn't. We just saw we can win. Tyr?
I won't allow prophecy to define my choices.
But we just saw
No, Atreus. This is wrong.
Come. There is much to discuss. Time.
We can't stop Ragnarok, but we can win it.
If Asgard is destroyed, Odin will not be the only casualty. There must be another way.
Perhaps we should focus on our egress first.
Agreed.
Redfall! Watch out!
Watch out!
Okay.
Now before more arrive.
It's gonna explode!
Find you!
Incoming!
Alpha!
We need to keep moving.
He's really worked up. Think he's okay?
Focus, Atreus.
This way.
Yeah!
Yeah!
It is over.
It is far from over.
It's gonna be okay, Tyr.
You've seen what is to come. I told you I would not follow you to war, and yet here I am, dragging an innocent elf and marching towards the destruction of Asgard.
What choice do we have?
There is always a choice. I will not lead you to war. I won't. I'm not that god anymore. I don't want to fight. But with you three, there is no avoiding it. Your path leads to countless deaths, unimaginable pain and suffering.
Oh no! No!
Atreus! Hold on!
Over here! You're chained!
Sir. Hey, Tyr? Thanks. And I'm sorry about before.
No. I am sorry. I should never have come. We shouldn't linger.
Look, I just want to do the right thing. And according to prophecy...
Speak no more of prophecy.
War will not give you the purpose you seek, Atreus. Only slaughter.
So what are we supposed to do? Roll over? Do nothing?
Enough! We will discuss our next move when we are out of danger.
Dark Elf Assault. How fortuitous.
I'm so sick of fighting elves. Can't they just leave us alone?
We need to get out of here. Through here!
Yappa!
Can we leave now, please?
Almost there. This way. Tyr, we...
Open the gateway, please. Yourself the legacy this one has left for the Barons. I've had far more than I can stomach.
We do not need to rush. We should see this desert for ourselves.
Look, I know we can't trust prophecy, but I'm not sure we should just ignore what we saw either.
We are not ignoring it. We will discuss it back home. For now, I wish to search for the wounded animal you heard earlier.
You? Really?
Yes.
Well, okay then. Good. Yeah. Lead the way.
Brother, you ever think of cooking meat with those blades of yours?
No. They would foul the meat.
Oh, because of the magic on them?
The blood.
Ah, yes. Carry on then.
Hail, fellow travelers.
Would have been a shame to have left that behind.
Atreus heard a creature in pain in the desert.
Over a storm like this? Most impressive.
You know Alfheim pretty well, right? Do you have any idea what's out there?
No, sorry. The elves and I... Long story, but it's best when we keep out of each other's way. Hive matter is... stickier than I care for. Good luck on your search, though. Stuff some cloth in your ears to keep the sand out. Don't knock it till you've tried it. Whatever you need. This axe just keeps getting stronger. I'll disinfect my tools.
What are these animals?
Gulon, native to Vanaheim. Not sure what they're doing here.
Someone trained them to pull a sled. Lucky for us.
Domesticated Gulon. Most unusual. Any particular direction to find your wounded animal? Or are we just enjoying the weather?
I can't hear anything out here.
Perhaps we find a cave first to catch our bearings? Not getting up there with all this sand in your way.
So much sand. I don't think we're getting through that gate in this storm.
A tempting treasure chest! Damn the sand!
There's a cave entrance!
This cave extends underneath the desert. Is the creature within?
Yeah, sounds like it. We'll find it if we keep going. What is this place?
A refuge for the Dark Elves, by the looks of it. One of the few remaining now that they're barred from the temple.
Great.
off!
Diablo!
Dark Elves. I wish we didn't have to fight them.
They attack us.
Well, this is their home. And considering what happened the last time we were in Alfheim, can you really blame them?
Patience. A virtue or a threat?
Depends on the reader.
Hmm.
creature you heard. What does it say now?
It's not always like that. Some animals are just... I feel what they're feeling, you know? And whatever this thing is, it's in a lot of pain.
I see.
Why do you ask?
I am curious.
Really?
I am capable of curiosity.
Okay. Okay. I've never been this interested before. When I talk to animals or enchanted rings or whatever.
Much has changed for both of us.
Well, yeah. I'm just trying to figure out why you'd help some random animal.
Is this not what you want?
No, it is. I'm just surprised it's what you want too.
Ugh.
To abandon it, but if we have to kill a bunch of Dark Elves to get there...
I remember a young lad whom, until this very moment, would take on an army of Draugr to save a wounded animal.
But these aren't undead Draugr. They're elves. I just want to make sure we're not repeating the same mistakes, getting involved where we shouldn't. That bomb should help us out. It's just... why does it feel like no matter what we do in Alfheim, we wind up hurting Dark Elves?
We are down here to help the creature you hurt.
I know that, but I'm usually the one who drags us around trying to rescue animals. Why do you care so much? Is there something you're not telling me?
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
Another nightmare!
To the left!
Incoming! Above you! Jump up!
Gefyun's ghost! That's the largest bloody half-goof I've ever laid eyes on!
It's not just in pain. It's trying to sing.
It's the Song of the Sands. They don't normally sing like this underground.
Is that what's causing the storm?
Aye. Judging by all this hive matter weighing it down, it's been trapped here for dozens of winters.
Don't worry, Lund. We'll get you out.
What is that name?
Well, the last squid thingy we saw was Diener, so...
Oh boy. While I appreciate the attempt at humor, that little brother is truly awful wordplay. Embarrassing, really.
Oh, well, can't all be winners. There's gotta be a way to clear those rocks. Get a better angle. Looks like it can move now, but it still can't get out.
Much of the hive matter is gone. We can free it from the surface now.
Why did they trap it down here?
Half-goofers are known to burrow, so I hesitate to place full blame on our dark elf friends.
But it's trapped in their hive stuff.
Hive matter doesn't belong to the Dark Elves, any more than the light belongs to the Light Elves. It's just another of Alfheim's natural resources, one the Elves have used since the time of their ancestors. And while the Light Elves seem keen to banish the Hive over on their side, the Dark Elves make effective use of it out here in the Barrens.
So, by clearing out all of this Hive, are we hurting Dark Elves?
You wish to leave the creature enslaved?
No.
Then let us free it.
This is the spot! We can cut the half goofa loose here!
It flies? Of course it flies! It's a half goofa!
Sounds much happier now! And hey! The storm's gone.
Aye. Perhaps we'll finally earn some goodwill from our Dark Elf friends after all.
Look, Father. Thanks for bringing us out here, but you don't have to do this kind of stuff just to keep my mind off Ragnarok, you know?
This was not a distraction.
No? Then why are we really out here?
Have you ever considered... He just wants to spend time with you, lad. While he still can.
Really?
We do not know what lies ahead. But if Ragnarok approaches, I wish to enjoy the time we have left.
I don't know what to say. Thank you for bringing us out here. I'm glad we did this.
As am I.
Should we get back to listing all the awful deeds of the Aesir gods? There was Groa, of course.
The Knowledge Keeper and Prophet of Ragnarok. Thor murdered her husband, and Odin covered it up before doing her in himself.
Let this wait. Stay alert.
Knock him down! Find you!
Look here.
You're building quite the collection of poetry, brother.
Why so surprised? My people are known for their culture.
Not surprised. Esteem.
Mimir, that big dwarf statue we saw. Who was he?
Alvis Stonefoot, Warden of Svartalfheim. He used his wisdom and might to imprison some of the most dangerous creatures in all the realm.
Odin stories to remember? I can't forget Ymir, the first giant.
Odin carved him up to form the realms from his body, and let the torrent of his blood nearly drown every giant alive.
Set that aside for now. Come. These runes.
What's that?
A diagram for a sword hilt.
Perhaps we should show it to one of the dwarves. They'll know what to do.
So not all dwarves can do that thing Brock and Sindri do, right? Or they just walk between realms and turn up somewhere else?
Indeed, that's a rare skill. I gather one carefully cultivated by some secretive dwarven guild or other. Probably for the best. Them alone doing it is disconcerting enough.
Looks like a lot of the sand is cleared up, but there's another storm out that way. You think that means...
Another Hafgufa!
The chisel will not open this.
Did the Light Elves put this lock here? Why would they care what happens in the Barrens?
A fair question, but until we find the right key, that poor Hafgufa will have to continue its slow act.
What is it, Mimir?
That's nothing, brother. Just... You ever have those moments where you wish you could... go back? Rewrite your own past. Make different decisions.
Journeying through time is more trouble than it is worth.
Ah, fair point. You're speaking metaphorically, right?
No.
Of course. Sort of a harp. I can play beautifully, you know.
I do not. I would prefer it remain that way.
Yeah!
What's the deal with Odin's ravens? They can just transport him anywhere?
Except for... The realm between realms, thankfully.
Why?
Harder to find, thanks to dwarven enchantments and Yggdrasil's very own nature.
Lucky us.
Atreus, you are getting better. Faster.
I'd even be better than you one day, huh?
If you are not, I have failed.
Oh.
Huh!
Mimir, I know this sounds weird, but can you tell me again what happens when someone dies?
Every living thing has a soul, and every soul has four parts. Form, mind, direction, and luck. Direction steers the souls of giants, dwarves, elves, and animals toward the Lake of Souls in Alfheim, where all the parts may be absorbed back into Alfheim's great light.
So that's where Fenrir is? The Lake of Souls?
So long as his soul still has its direction, aye, it's well on its way.
A while ago, you mentioned Odin's ravens. What's to stop him from using them to pop into existence and kidnap anybody he wants?
Consent. The only way to travel by Odin's ravens is by your own choice.
Oh, it's not so bad then. Nice to see you out here, Sindri. You must hate the sand.
Oh, it is the worst. But with Brock banned from Alfheim, it's up to me to keep you ship-shape and sharp.
So why is Brock banned from Alfheim?
Oh, that's, I don't know if... Well, do you know what a juicy gnocchi is?
No.
Well, thanks to Brock, the elves sure do.
What is a juicy...
No.
What'll it be? And in pristine condition, too.